How could I be happy without the one thing that makes me happy? These are tissues. These are tissues that I've had since my ex broke up with me. These are tissues where I cried real tears in the moment during the breakup. I've had those tissues ever since I moved out from the place where I cried into them in, which was the place that me and my ex were living together. I've had them in one place in my room. They haven't moved there. I'm gonna put a picture up. And they just represent to me that things weren't always so great. And it's a very different contrast to the way that I live today. Today, I'm pretty happy. I mean, I'm in this beautiful area here that I'm walking around in. And it's amazing. I love it. I didn't know that this was even waiting for me on the other side of that breakup. During that breakup, there were days that I was on the floor, fetal position, crying the entire day. That breakup was agonizing. We had been together for 6 years, and it felt like my whole life was going down a drain. So I had a hard time with it. It wasn't something that I wanted to experience. It was not a relationship that I wanted to let go of. I was in pain constantly. Then there were the days when I couldn't do much of anything and I didn't feel much of anything. All I felt was no motivation, tired, like there was nothing I could do because there really wasn't anything that I could do. The thing that I wanted wasn't going to happen. And when I wasn't on the floor crying, when I wasn't in the bed feeling like there was nothing that I could do, I was in complete panic mode. I was obsessively trying to figure out how to change this. How do I get away from this? So there was no room for happiness in my life. And on the off chance that maybe, just maybe, I would feel something a little bit happy, it always reminded me of my ex. And when I thought of my ex, I was brought right back to the sadness and despair. And you know what? All of this is normal to experience after a breakup. That's how our body reacts when we're perceiving a loss of something. So even on those days when it felt like maybe there's something wrong with me, or maybe things that other people said made me feel like there was something wrong with me, there was nothing wrong with me, and there's nothing wrong with you if you're experiencing those feelings after a breakup. What I found as time went on is that I would have a little bit more of those moments where something good would happen, where I would feel happy. You know, I had spent enough time in the sadness and the depression and all the other feelings that space opened up and I could acknowledge that there were happy things happening in my life. They still reminded me of my ex and I still got sad, but each time I repeated them, each time I saw them and noticed them, the feelings for my ex started to move out of the way and allow the happiness to come in. Over time, those happy feelings grew. You know, when I looked at something, I didn't get caught on my ex. I didn't always associate happy feelings with my ex only. I started to realize I can feel happy feelings and not have the image of my ex come back into my head. That kind of took some training, I think. I think I needed to consciously distract myself from thinking of my ex when those happy feelings were coming. But eventually, over time, they started to crowd out the space of where my ex was. When I took the time to look for the good in the world, I found it. What are some good things that happened to you this week? Leave them down below in the comments.